Okay, so with those changes in the past couple of sessions done and the data pool pretty much ready to for initial use anyways, probably some fine-tuning required still. It's time to go back to what started all that, trying to implement the physics. Or at least the first bring up of physics. Let me see, I have the basic type. ID, which would be okay. What I want to do is I want to have the two distinct types like actually declared here. So I mean they're basically just renames, but it'll help keep things a little bit cleaner. So faux resource ID. That's specifically a resource ID. You're looking for them in resource pools. Bring that down. Okay. Moving back down to state pools, which kind of started this with the necessity of figuring out what was added and removed. Include. Oh, data pool like that. We're going to have a data pool, which takes faux resource. No, ID. Physics rigid body type. Bodies too. Amazing. And this isn't going to die. If I actually just like template class this, that's going to just do nothing, right? No errors going to crop up. Right, I updated the ID header, that's quite heavy. But it does not break, which is good. Okay. Backing that up. I was going to. Okay, so I have this in the state pools. Move that over. Which body? Something in the system. The system takes in the state pools. For processing physics in here. Okay, this is kind of one of the larger things. We have init physics, so the physics world's gravity. Adding rigid bodies, removing rigid bodies, processing physics. Okay. Actually, that's one thing I wanted. Before I do that, I need to actually start running maintenance, so like rigid 2 maintenance. This will have to be called. Well, for now I'm just going to use it as a like I'm going to add all the types in here for maintenance. What will hopefully happen down the line is that it'll be more fine-tuned, so you'll only perform certain maintenance of certain sets of data sets while other data sets are being processed, so you can kind of like stagger them out rather than having like one whole bunch of maintenance at once. But for the time being, make my life a little bit easier, I'm actually going to make sure that all these are performed at once around like what it has to be once per tick to keep this the idea going. So we'll put it really close to the top. After event processing, getting these. Processing user input. Then we'll do like maintenance. Whatever. State. Where do we get it? What's it called? Oh, no, it'd be from the current simulation set, right? Yes. Okay. Every time we come through here, we now have maintenance. Insertions and removals are done. So back to this. I'm going to need to do two things currently. Okay. We need to. Okay. First of all, is always removals. We remove things that were removed because some other things may have been inserted in the meantime. So. What we're going to do is. Items auto. ID iterator equals. What am I looking at? It's a pointer. That's a pointer. So something like that. For that, ID iterator not equal ID end iterator. Something like that. Now we've removed it. Okay, it was removed from the pool. So, give me this. If, okay. It's not equal to null pointer. That means it's part of the pool, which means we need to do fizz world or remove rigid body this. Like that, right? The pointer to it. From BT rigid body to what? Oh, okay, I see what's right. Okay, so actually, no, this one line will do the job here. Data iterator. Like that. And we do with insertions. This is an offset iterator. Okay. Offset iterator. These are size T's, aren't they? Why would they be like? Because the maximum value is U in 32, anyways. Yeah, whatever. The thing that matters here is. Okay, not really what I'm looking for. Okay, first thing, can I do like a debug thing? If const expression debug? Is there like a const expression debug? File commands. We're in debug mode right now, so deb. No. If I was to change like release. There is. Oh, end debug. Maybe. Okay, how about for the moment we just do like a C assert. When you're inserting, there sh th this the rigid body should always be null pointer. There should be like nothing, absolutely nothing. This thing should be constructing it. To my mind, yes. So assert that p data rigid. Is null pointer. Okay, otherwise we need to add it. It requires us doing this stuff. Do 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 p data trash these for the moment. And then a step simulation. Go back to debug mode. And make sure we're not doing any awful things with address. Sanitizer. Wait for that to compile. Okay, that's done. I mean, this isn't even going to be used yet, is it? But I want to make sure, because I don't actually have any physics. I do have physics here. I don't actually add any. I do. So something should be falling. Okay, interesting. Okay. Why is this happening? Because I don't have data. I don't have the data. The data is currently in the other. Okay. Git stash. Git rebase onto save load, which has the data. Okay. Now we have the data, right? It's in here. The data A. Yeah, we got stuff. Perfect. Do this again. And here we are. We're on the removals. They just be null pointer, right? So just gives it. Insertions, though, there should be something. Cool. This is what I like to see. Nothing. Oh, yes, I'm not actually adding the data yet. Yeah. So go to state.rigidbodies2.insert. I'm going to insert this. Render mesh ID. This. That. Cool. Now we come back through and have a look. Because it should be a moment after this, right? This happens first. If I check this, P simulation. Whatever. I'll just find out in a second. Then it comes down to here, processing physics. We're here. We got something. Yes, maybe. Zero. Okay, it's real, though. Hold on. This is what I'm looking for. So what I'm going to do is instead I'm going to P data at the offset of that. Okay. That makes more sense. Let's do that. Okay, so we added it. Next time we come through, there's nothing to remove, there's nothing to insert. And then we're just going to watch absolutely nothing happen. Cool. Yes, of course, it's up there, that's why. Let's log. I know it'll be there, just for the moment. Just want to make sure that if I do this, rigid body. This is what I'm looking for right here. Get rid of that, so it becomes this rigid body, that okay, so it's going down somewhere in the ether, which is good. It's just not connected to anything else right now. So that means what I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of this one. We'll replace that with that. Okay, no, first of all, we'll make sure that, hey, is there anything else that was attached to that? Yes, there was. First of all, there's this. Makes sense. Then on another line, nope. No. Okay, now we replace them. This. And in application, get back to this. Next, I'm going to have to figure out a way to hook up the physics, like the position, orientation, rotation stuff. I need to get this hooked up to communicate outside of this type, obviously, in some kind of connected fashion. I'm hoping that I can do it in a connected fashion anyways. I don't want to have to, like, have, like, position data in the position pointer that I have to copy to the physics object when it updates, or have the physics object otherwise do its own stuff and then copy that back to the position. I'd like for them to be tied together. I know I can't tie it together for the render position because that has to be copied into a memory location which gets put on the graphics card. So that's kind of out of my wheelhouse, but I can at least tie these together since they stay on the CPU the whole time. I mean, physics processing units died with Agia decades ago. And the sad excuse of whatever NVIDIA did with it is just, not worth thinking about. Okay. Safety, safety. Position 3D, like, this is pretty, I mean, that's a temporary thing as well. But I may not actually have much of a choice right now. I can't really think of a good, clean way to do it right now. That doesn't mean I won't necessarily have one in the future. So what I'll do is I'll have a terrible, hacky half solution, which will be so bad that I will have to update it and fix it up in the future. Which makes sense. Okay, actually, if I want to tie things together, I need the ability to determine when positions are inserted and removed as well. Because for this to tie together, I need to have that as well. Yeah. Okay. State pools this. We're going to do this. We're going to faux data pool. And this positions two. Maintenance on that. And then what we're going to do is for the moment. Position there. So it's render. Okay. It's almost the same as this, really. This position 2.insert. Rid of that. This is, Not great, but it'll have to work. What I'm going to do is have a, let's say, a function. What's going to have to happen in this? If I add object. Okay, yeah. We'll have entity ID. We'll have the, what is this called? Rigid body state? That. From where is it? No, it's just position 3D. It's not even a foe type. Okay. And you know what? Eventually we'll have BT collision shape. Actually makes sense. So we'll have at least one, if not more, items. Then we have to go around and collect all the items we don't have. So rigid body, then we'll have to collect the position shape. Equals null pointer. There are probably ways I can optimize this, but no, not right now. No, right now it's the basics. Gotta get it working. So if that. If we found it, plus data offset, so we have it. Otherwise, we return. Same thing would have to happen for position. We need to make sure that we have both of these types together. I mean, you can't add an object with just which just has a rigid body information and no position, and vice versa. And eventually, collision shape will be another constraint. So if p position. We weren't given it as part of the function. plus. Temporary stuff. So the, at this point, then we have to go through this stuff. So what's going to happen is it's going to basically add object. Don't even really need this. What we need is that. We're provided with this. End of that. We're not provided with that, but we are provided with the collision shape. Is that all the time right now? We can, or it's and rigid body really. And then in a moment, we'll probably have to do the same thing for removal. Because when we're doing a removal, I wouldn't actually know if we need everything. We'd need the collision shape to alert it that we've removed a dependency on it. But position? Whatever. For the moment, let's... Does add object? Does this work? Does it work? That's the question. So we still have this, yeah. Okay. So this would insert rigid body. So we'd have another one that would be like for any position 3D types that were added in. Same idea, basically. Except for like this, and that, and that, and that. Similar idea. We don't really want to have this here, would we? Well, I can't do an assert here because it may actually be added. Because if I'm calling the same thing, if I only have a position, well, no, how? If the position was only just added, then it could not possibly have had a rigid body available anyways. So yes. Okay, I need to assert. Yeah, I need to assert that you're like that. And then I could just like do this. In this case, we got a null pointer here. And instead, this is a position object. No, because, yeah, if we come through and he was added, then it's going to crap out. Because, yeah, I have no guarantee that this will be the case. So I need to check to make sure, you know, if... Okay. Cute. I really enjoy going through the templates. Thank you. Amazing. Okay, we're here. We were given this. We have to find the position, and we do. And then we go ahead and add it. Amazing. Now, if it was the opposite order, say we're working on position first. We don't, this was not given, right? Yes, it's null pointer. You have the entity, the data pools, position is given. You get it, you found it, we are adding it this way, right? No problem. Okay. Okay. Put them back. We'd need the same thing up here for removals. Sorry, what the hell's going on here? We got that? Okay, that's great. What? 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 Okay. Okay. Whatever. Removing, 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 removing. I don't really need that stuff. What I do need is the rigid body. I just need the entity. Okay, yeah. That's what I need. If I don't have it, then we just return. Otherwise, we're going to have to call the remove stuff, which involves removing the rigid body. And then I need to reset. That. Yeah. Even need this. I just need to iterate through those. Okay. For the moment, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to have to like. Okay, just for the moment. Yeah, the really awful thing. Really, really awful. Auto. So this should actually be pretty, I mean, this is a pretty, well, simple system for in, it should keep the system pretty functional and bug-free. Like, things are added only when they have to be, and they are easily removed before you get to the process of simulation. It the biggest downside is, quite frankly, the fact that a lot of data is going to... Like, you have to think in terms of, well, what I add now or what I remove now will be here for this current tick and won't be... The insertion and removal won't actually be actioned until the next tick. Which, like, if an engine's fast enough, it's like 1/60th of a second, you know, 1/100th of a second, which I would hope it's okay to be on screen for another 10, 16 milliseconds. Whatever, or something like that. As long as it's not available for the next frame is what really matters. Like, you do logic now to remove and insert stuff, and a lot of this stuff takes effect on the next frame, rather than being actioned this frame for insertions and removals of physics, visual rendering, information, audio, whatever. Having a one frame lag, to my mind, should be workable. Okay, what was I even doing? Off track. That was an off track. Copying position data to position 3D objects. Okay, we are going to be starting with okay. I could do something smart, but I'm not going to do it quite smart yet, to my mind. I know that auto... Yeah, I'm going to just do it the dumb way right now. I need to make sure that what I'm doing is going to work first. Star PID. Assert that position offset should not be the set that. So we found the offset, now we want how do I do this? Do I actually include this? Yeah, maybe. Yes, I do. Okay. I'd get a Euler angle back out for everything else, wouldn't I? So I've got a BT transform that I want to change to this. Okay. So I got that. There'll be a GLM D no. Documentation time. Decompose is what I'm looking for. Okay. GLM GTX matrix decompose. Looks like need a few items. This is definitely hacky. Excellent. Scale. Going to decompose the transform. Scale, rotation, translation, skew, and perspective. Then I can p position. Position equals translation. Would I have to conjugate this? Maybe. You know what? Actually, first of all, let's have a look at what this is going to do. I presume that's the object there. So it's definitely not taking any effect there. Of course, it's not taking any effect. This thing doesn't even go anywhere. It's still using the old position pool, this thing. Let's see if we can change that right now. Okay, we have this. We're going to add, okay. the same thing. I'm sorry, come on. What's going on here? That's right. Get out of here. Positions 2 dot size. Position and so star all that. Okay. Doing about an hour in. Okay, if I go down, way down here, position pool stuff. Okay. Let's put a pin in that for the moment, shall we? Rather, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the position as well. So P state pools position that will also be this. We'll just put into both for the moment and see what happens. Nothing super catastrophic. Okay. See what's going on. Is it going to fly by? Come on, fly by, fly by. No. Oh, well, yeah, okay. There it goes. There it went. And there it goes. Forever, I guess. Maybe I just have a really limited sight range right now. Right? Or my, holy crap, what, like, what the hell? My perspective is all off. Like, it just disappears instantly. If I look down, I don't understand. Wait, hold on. What the hell's going on with the perspective, actually? Something is very wrong. Like, if it's normal, I look down, and then I look back up. Oh, yeah, okay. Like, look at that. It's like I'm rotating around the triangle rather than... Something is very wrong with the movement. Okay. Okay, one thing at a time. One thing at a time. At the moment, I have physics. It's hooked up to positions very, very... Very rickety, but it is there. I've got a fairly robust and simple system for managing insertions and removals. Still using a single physics world and collision object that's static in here. If I want to advance from here, I could, okay, I can either add collision shapes as a resource, or, yeah, okay, I'll add collision shapes now. I can kind of add this later, position two. Realistically, for the moment, I know it exists. Oh no, but I need it right now because I added that code in. Yeah, okay. Okay. I'm going to take a quick break and then I'll be right back in a moment for collision shapes. Getting that resource added. Okay. Do I want to put in faux resource? Not really, because what I'm probably going to do is I'm going to like put all the resources, like all the physics items, into like a faux physics library, which of course inherits faux resource. I think. So actually, I'm going to put it down here. So what I need is. No, I don't think there's really anything specific I need to add that I'm going to do with physics. Like, I'm not going to extend the basic bullet collision shape yet. I can imagine I probably will soon. But if that's the case, no, I'll just do it like that, really. I really need to come up with a better pool type for resources as well. No, there will have to be, because I need all the resource specific stuff. Got that. Hit this. Not sure what's going to go in there quite yet. these. I can probably just copy over from the old one. And these are all the basic types, really. Mesh. It would be closer to mesh, wouldn't it? With a predefined. Public stuff is pretty much the same still. Error code. Need this? No. I don't really have an upload system either, though. So this will be closer to really the armature pool again. Not the armature pool, the armature loader. Initialized? Why is there initialized here? What does this do? Oh, I need, yeah, that stuff. Okay, yeah. For sure, I'm going to have to do something to simplify this loader, resource loading in some fashion, because it's a little much. The entire ecosystem for resources is a little too much, I have to admit. It's just not great. Not great. So that means I'm going to have to delve back into these things after this. Again, I'm trying to centralize it a little too much in here. Error code. That's all I had. Actually loading the resource. no, that's processing create info. After I already loaded the data in from the third party. Okay, if that's the case, we can continue with this. And then, wait, where on earth does it do the low? Okay, what, wait, where does it do this? Process create info. There it is, okay. If you couldn't find it, turn, go to loading failed, it's not quite there yet. Process create info. Okay, now we have to go through the stuff for processing loaded items. There are, what am I going to do with this? First of all, we'll just say, like, how do I make one of these? It's like a collision shape, box shape of size. So I can do box shape, I can do sphere. Collision shape. Something like that. For the moment, we'll just have the one type, which is just box shapes. Make things a little bit easier. No, it'd be a bool of some sort. Okay, just getting everything going. Okay, so here we got system, we got resource slash. I've got an extra thing for shape pool, right? Just almost should effectively really be a template as well. Yeah, okay. I've got the collision shape thing here. Armature pool on this side. And this is basically the exact same thing as always. Right, these loaders need to be changed for that. And actually have the right one. Okay. So that's still holding together. Resource pools. No, it's just other for now. Oh, yes, because it's not exported, is it? Okay, it's better for linking. Okay. I'll want to put that in the error code change at least. The intention is to base library. So what's going? Oh, yeah, because of different locations. That makes sense. Well, that's nice to see that that is actually having an effect. Okay. What's this? ID operational area. Okay, there's a lot of stuff going on. Let's clear all these up again. So we've got the collision, that shape loader, pool. I'd also, you know what? What are we doing here? What are we doing for time? Okay, it's coming up to 2 hours. So I'm going to kind of hold here for now. Now that I have a good implementation of collision shape, but it's not really done, and I'll finish it up next time. Well, where I'm going to put this into a separate library, I'm going to add the YAML interaction, import export, and get this collision shape part at least done, because that's still going to be a number of hours of work, I bet. All right, cheers.